Bashir, but now must be wondering how that was ever possible as he falls further and further behind. As Alan continues on, he sees Polly Hiru, who has recovered from his disastrous flat, to take over third place. Bustos presses on as he makes the final turnaround. Alan urgently presses toward a record. In a matter of 3 miles, a dead heat has been transformed into a lead of great proportions, as Bustos is literally left stranded along the barren highway, no longer hoping for the lead.
Weld, reduced to a walk again, can barely acknowledge the passing of Alan, who has beaten him again. With just over 7 miles to go, Alan now pays closer attention to his running pace. Alan, the man who spent 3 solitary days and nights in the wilderness to prepare for this race, is alone again. Welch's medical condition has caused concern among race doctors.
Hi,
he has an important decision to make. Should he quit the race or push on?
How you feeling?
All right.
Yeah?
I'm picking on, but I think I'm having some problems.
Yeah. I heard you were spitting up some blood. Are you okay?
Yeah, but it's I had a hemorrhoid. I had surgery 2 weeks ago, so I'm not feeling too good, but I'm going to keep going. If I feel like pulling out, I will.
Okay.
We're gonna keep a
real tight eye on you over the next couple of weeks or the next couple of minutes,
yeah.
And we'll be right behind you with the van. Okay?
No worries.
All right, hang in there.
The doctor attending to Greg Welch out on the course is one of 200 members of the Gatorade Ironman medical staff. Most are located here at the medical tent near the finish line. Virtually all the competitors you see here are being treated for dehydration. Over the course of the day, some Ironman competitors will lose more than 5 gallons of fluid. Failure to properly hydrate results in exhaustion. These IV solutions are being prepared for competitors who visit the medical tent after the race. Of those who will take an IV, most do so to speed recovery from the effort of the race rather than medical necessity. However, the vast majority of the athletes are spared a visit to the medical tent by making use of the aid stations along the course. There, they find fluids, including over 13,000 gallons of Gatorade, a fluid replacement drink scientifically designed to replace the precious fluids lost on the course. Volunteers from local businesses and civic organizations get the Gatorade into the hands of the competitors. Inexperienced athletes rarely do well in the Ironman. Veterans like Mark Allen and Paula Newby-Fraser approach the race with specific plans for drinking fluids before, during, and after the race. And for Paula Newby-Fraser, victory may be assured. She takes on fuel so that she too can try to break her own course record.
The finish line awaits when we return after these messages.
Focused on the goal of mastering the Ironman, balanced the 3 disciplines of the triathlon in 8-hour training days, and discovered the path to Ironman success in 1989. He's racing toward a record 4th straight victory. Chile's Christian Bustos took up the triathlon in 1984 after watching the Ironman on TV. He began the day a virtual unknown, but has emerged from obscurity. Paula Newby-Fraser wants to inspire women to find fulfillment through sports. Today, she's beaten all but a handful of men in the race. Jim McLaren was pronounced dead, languished in a coma for 6 days, and lost a leg. He's on his way to completing his third Ironman. Kathy Hughes tends a farm, takes care of 5 kids, teaches aerobics, and coaches basketball. She may be the ultimate cross-trainer. Pat Rummerfield competes to reassert his triumph over paralysis and to encourage others to believe in miracles. And it will take more than one rough day to dampen the spirits of Greg Welch. He'll be back to Kona.
Alan has raced brilliantly throughout the day. Staving off numerous challenges in all phases of the race, he now emerges as the true champion of this event. Most wondered when the charm would wear off. Certainly he would eventually have to be beaten. But for the man who gained so much spiritual strength from this mystical island, he is about to accomplish something not even the great Dave Scott could do. Win 4 straight Ironman titles. The final mile through the streets of Kona are as familiar to Alan as any street in the world. The cheers of those who await him are as recognizable as any single voice. Paula Newby Fraser knows those cheers as well, and soon she too will be among them. Rounding the final turn, Alan embarks on a Lee Drive. To the sport of triathlon, this is almost sacred ground. This is the final stretch of road, a time to bask in glory. This is the dream for all who start the race. This is home. His record is 8 hours, 9 minutes, 15 seconds. The record is seconds within reach. Mark Allen is within yards of the tape. And as he crosses the threshold, Mark Allen has done it. The time, 8 hours, 9 minutes, 8 seconds. Yet another chapter added to a storied Iron Man career. Embraced by his wife, Julie Moss, who inspired him to run this race 10 years ago. Bustos carries the flag of his nation. He'll return to Chile as a true hero. He'll return to the Iron Man no longer as an unknown. Craig Massbach is at the finish line with the champion.
Mark Allen, focus, balance, discovery, a record 4th straight Ironman victory.
Thanks. I didn't think I could do it today. I came out of the water a little bit behind Welch, and I thought, uh-oh, that's the race. And Bustos was really pushing it on the run, much harder than I thought he could. And I thought, well, I guess second or third or fourth won't be too bad. But he started to slow down out there, and the record, unbelievable.
Well, that's right. The record, your own record that you set in 1989 when you won your first Ironman victory, that was on a tougher course. Did you think you could set another record?
No, I thought it would be really hard. But I guess somehow I pulled it out.
Bustos' celebrated finish continues. And the man he pushed for so long and so hard awaits him at the finish line. Mark Allen and Christian Bustos meet again. This time, Allen has an appreciative hug for such a hard-fought race. Back on the course, there seems to be a fresh spring to Greg Welch's legs. The scarf